The following contest, scheduled for one fall, is for the WWE Women's Tag Team Championship! Introducing first, the team of Candice LeRae and Australia's own Indy Hartwell!
An emotional night, Corey, for Indy Hartwell here. She was born and raised in Melbourne. She trained at the PCW Academy there. She was part of Riot City Wrestling and World Series Wrestling here in Australia. Now LeRae's got a chance, Corey. Tag, here's Indy Hartwell.
Australia's own teeing off on the tag team champions.
Hartwell taking out Asuka, taking out Sane.
Meeting of the minds.
And Indy fired up with an opportunity to win the tag team titles in her homeland. Spine buster.
Double stacked.
For the win. And the tag team titles. And a kick out by Asuka. Challengers doing a great job tagging in and out of the ring.
I think we're going to need to see some more urgency from the challengers.
Off the top rope, and Kairi Sane gets involved, and LeRae crashes and burns.
Like, I know what I'm talking about.
But in the end, the Kabuki Warriors pick up the victory and retain the tag team titles. Nice ovation for Indy and Candice here tonight. Corey and I will be back at the top of the hour with the start of Elimination Chamber.
Making her way to the ring from Prior Lake, Minnesota, Tiffany Stratton!
Might have something to do with the international dateline, Michael Cole, but can you tell me what time it is?
Yeah, it's Tiffy time. Now, Tiffany Stratton beat Zelina Vega to qualify for this Elimination Chamber match tonight. She picked up a big victory over Liv Morgan last night on Friday Night SmackDown. She could be a dark horse in this event.
I completely agree with you, Cole. Tiffany Stratton to this point has absolutely lived up to the hype, but we're going to find out a lot about Tiffany in this particular matchup, because inside the chamber, there is no hype. Just flesh and steel and five opponents willing to tear you to shreds to take what you want.
A former NXT Women's Champion as well. She said she's looking to become the youngest Elimination Chamber winner ever.
So as you're watching the action unfolding in front of you, you have to realize that at any moment, your pod may swing open, and you are now responsible for your own destiny.
And Naomi scaling the chain link here in the chamber.
Tremendous athleticism being displayed by Naomi.
And driving Becky face first into the steel.
Lynch was able to get her elbows in front of her to mitigate the impact.
Time.
Not that time at all.
This chamber is 16 feet tall. It weighs 10 tons, 2 miles of chain, and Naomi with a split leg drop off the chamber. And Tiffany Stratton will enter the fray.
Tonight, the center of the universe can be found in Perth, Australia.
You saw the rankings on top of the pods at the WWE 2K video game rankings. Always controversial. Tiffany Stratton with a 79, and I don't think she'd be happy with that. And Stratton now showing off.
Tiffany Stratton extremely early on in her career here in WWE, but wasting no time making an impact of her own.
Yeah, showing off that Team USA gymnastics background. Cover on Becky. Hook of the leg and a kick out by Lynch. And now a Naomi who's got a kick out as well. And we mentioned earlier that rough and tough style of Liv Morgan really made for the Elimination Chamber.
You say rough and tough, I say borderline reckless. Liv Morgan not afraid to sacrifice her own well-being to take out her opponent.
Yeah, going right after Stratton, driving her into the pod. Stratton knocked off Morgan last night, and now Morgan making her pay. And Tiffany Stratton, welcome to Elimination Chamber. Liv Morgan knows how to do damage inside.
Submission may not technically happen outside of the ring, but Lynch may have just damaged Tiffany's arm irreparably.
Now Liv Morgan!
Stomping Tiffy through the mat.
And now Naomi up on top of a pod.
Oh my
Naomi
God!
The sunset flip powerbomb from the top of the pod! Stratton the
cover! Takes advantage! Tiffy stole it!
Naomi has been eliminated.
What a brilliant decision by Tiffany Stratton.
Looking across the ring at one another.
I like this.
And Belair taking the fight to Rodriguez. Bianca just lifted. Oh, and Bianca with her own counter.
Oh,
and now lifting Raquel. Not quite. Oh!
And I don't think that was an absence of power by Belair. I just don't think Bianca had her footing under her well enough to hoist Raquel up.
And Raquel Rodriguez now dragging Belair over the top rope. Outside,
uh-oh,
looking up.
Uh-oh.
Raquel looking for a vertical suplex, this time with Belair.
But,
and Bianca, she was able to counter Corey.
Yeah, Bianca.
Oh, what a DDT!
Oh, no, no, no. Lynch looking for the manhandle slam. This will be the end of Tiffy time.
Tiffany Stratton able to counter, though, and now Stratton shoves Lynch into Raquel off the top of the pod. And what does Stratton do now? You don't think.
Look, I certainly hope not. No, 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 no. Swanton takes out the field. A truly global event. The eyes of the WWE Universe locked on Perth, Australia. And right now, Liv Morgan and Becky Lynch doing their best to take one another out. You hear the thud of the impact each time Liv strikes Lynch in the back.
And now superplex.
Morgan now.
Belair.
Oh!
Oh my goodness!
450, but Becky got the knees up!
Is your winner, the man, Becky Lynch!
What great ring awareness by Becky Lynch.
That ring awareness made all the difference. But the ring awareness is why Becky Lynch has headlined WrestleMania. Why she is headed there yet again with another golden opportunity to become Women's World Champion.
So Becky Lynch earns an opportunity for the Women's World Championship. And in 42 nights.
And they're a poop.
What a fool.
Who are you talking about?
Dom.
I mean, Dirty Dom's like only a couple feet from us, Cole. If he hears you,
oh, and a cheap shot by Mysterio. What is that? What is that?
What?
What is that? You shouldn't even be out here. And now Pete Dunne sends Balor out of the ring, and Dominic realizes Judgment Day is in trouble.
Question is, does the Judgment Day realize it? Look at the bruiserweight.
Done top rope, moonsault!
The challengers throwing everything they have at the champions.
And oh. Done. Tyler Bate trying to lift Priest up on his shoulders yet again. This time, does he have enough power and strength? He does. Little airplane spin coming.
Is Bate doing that in the opposite direction since we're in Australia? That's a myth, by the way. I tested it out.
I'm sure you did. Look at Bate go.
Oh, my God. We could be here all night.
Bate is still going. Revolution after revolution.
I think Damian Priest may wake up in Oz after that.
Done now. Bitter end.
We're going to have new champions.
Cover for the win. And Dominic. Well, you're not smart at all. Right there, ref, right there.
Who did that?
He did that.
Who did that?
Yeah!
I don't know. I think that might be too far.
Thanks for coming. Thanks for coming, Dom.
All because Dom allegedly interfered in this match.
People's champion. That is a grand and lofty title, one that you cannot self-appoint, and maybe at one point The Rock was the people's champ. Maybe it's just me, but I think to be the people's champ, you have to actually be around the people. You know what? Seth, the World Heavyweight Champion, had a bit of an announcement. I feel like I think I have a bit of an announcement myself. Rock, you indeed slapped me across the face. And at WrestleMania 40, I am wrestling Roman Reigns in the main event. But until then, I am wide open. So let's make it official. Rock, I want to wrestle you one-on-one, anytime, any place. Maybe not.
This is unique.
Ineffective. KO is on cheerleader. Oh my goodness. McIntyre beaten and battered.
We are approaching the next entry. The countdown is on.
Number 5, 7 winners over the years. The fray for the 9th time in his career. The Viper, Randy Orton, goes right after LA Knight and Kevin Owens.
Viper, the freshest of the crew right now.
What a clothesline!
Wow. And again.
Power slam. The United States champion with a perfect opportunity. Well, Kevin Owens though, back on his feet. Kevin Owens back on his feet, trying to rip the pot open. Logan Paul wants to stay inside, and now the fight's out. Kevin Owens and Logan Paul inside the pod. Kevin Owens has locked the pod.
It's a fist fight in a phone booth.
Kevin Owens cannot wait to get his hands on Logan Paul. Well, Kevin Owens, I thought he locked himself in.
Here comes the Almighty. That's driven through the pod.
I think Bobby Lashley's finished playing games.
I think you're right about that. Stalking the Maverick. Here comes the Almighty.
For the win.
What the hell?
AJ Styles!
Where the hell did AJ Styles come from?
He's coming to score for the Aces.
Styles is mangling LA Knight with a steel chair.
Corey, where the hell did Styles come from?
I have no idea. There's so many bodies in the ring. There are superstars. There's officials. There's AJ Styles.
And did he come in through the open door that they opened up to get Lashley out?
It may have been the case. We saw Logan Paul do something similar last year at the expense of Rollins. But
AJ Styles, who's had this long simmering rivalry with LA Knight. LA Knight cost Styles an opportunity to be in this chamber match tonight, and Styles has not forgotten that.
Styles feels as though LA Knight cost him a chance to knock off Roman Reigns.
Styles clash on the chair. He's going to WrestleMania to face Seth Rollins for the World Heavyweight Championship. Logan Paul says this could be my opportunity. Logan Paul digging down deep. There are the brass knuckles. And they're legal inside the chamber because there's no disqualification. Logan Paul can do anything he wants with the brass knucks that helped him win the United States Championship over Rey Mysterio.
Given the choice between the knuckles and Jeff himself, I'd say Logan made the right choice tonight.
Listen to this place!
McIntyre grinning from ear to ear.
He's got Orton right where he wants him. RKO out of nowhere!
Or does he?
Logan Paul with the brass knuckles! That damn Logan Paul just hit Orton with the damn knuckles!
I just wanted to come out here for a second to say thank you. On behalf of the WWE, on behalf of every superstar back there, thank you for inviting us into your home. Thank you for being great hosts. Thank you for this wonderful Optus Arena. It's been an incredible night, and I want to let you know the attendance here tonight, the official attendance, 52,590.
Absolutely awesome. Thank you for everything, Kurt. It has been a blast.
And we are not done yet.
It is.
Yeah.
has been beaten up by Jax. And Nia with a forearm.
Nia trying to position Rhea for something more favorable. This will not end well.
Nia Jax with Rhea up on her shoulders through the second rope. Rhea high above the ring. Massive Samoan drop. That could be the end of the championship reign. Cover on the champion. Kick out at two by Ripley. Jax is going for the Annihilator. Rhea Ripley now with Nia on her shoulders. Face first off the turnbuckle. Nia hit hard.
I think Nia might be out.
Nia hit hard.
Guttural howl from the women's world champion trying to summon Australia to come with her.
Rhea Ripley, top rope. Just like Eddie would do.
Frog splash.
Cover on Nia Jax. Kicks out at two.
Ladies, no. Inside, Rhea, listen up. No.
No way. No way.
Rhea Ripley trying to lift Nia up. Can she do it? Not quite. Nia Jax, though.
Samoan drop onto our announce table. And Nia Jax right now, there's that million-dollar smile on a wrecking ball.
Rhea Ripley. Drop right on the announce table, through the monitors, through the table.
Oh, God!
Elbow, and down goes Ripley. And Nia's gonna put this away.
Sacrificing herself to put the champion down, and this could do it.
Annihilator, cover on Ripley for the championship. Rhea kicks out. Rhea kicked out. Headbutt by Nia. Trying to create space again.
I am so impressed with the confidence of Nia Jax.
Nia Jax is going to go up to the... She's going up to the top rope.
Rhea's got new tricks. So does Nia.
Rhea Ripley going to meet her there.
No way.
We'll be right back.